two of you, right over here. Hello, good morning. Go ahead and have a seat right over there. Have a seat. So my goal for students during the first day of school is not only to get acclimated to the environment, get acclimated to each other, but for me to also introduce myself, but get to know them and get to know their personalities or learning styles and how they respond to the environment. So fill that out. If you have any questions, at your computer is a little light. Turn that red if you have a question. I will be coming by to answer your questions. All right? So if you have any questions, please turn it red. All right, I'll be coming around to check in with you. So the very first day they get that job application, that STEM application, because if you go to a job, that's the first thing you're doing. You're filling out that job application, you're showing your interest, you're showing why you're qualified, and I want that the students to have that experience doing it. It's a modified job application, but more educational. But it gets them preparing for that college, getting prepared for that career, by getting used to filling out the applications for things. Students come in thinking rules, procedures, but that's a nice little break for them where, okay, I'm applying for a job. I'm applying for this position within this STEM program. And then day two, three, it takes off from there. They go into their orientation. While they're filling out that job application, I'm also going around and I'm introducing myself. I'm seeing little things that they're writing down and making those connections, asking those probing questions, learning their culture. Okay, middle school students have a very different culture than us adults, and you wanna see what they're interested in and make those connections, have those conversations. It kind of shapes how I teach each year. So I know if this game or this show is really important, then I know I can make those connections throughout within the curriculum. Well, you're definitely rebuilding things. You like to paint?
Yeah.
Nice. Do you use acrylic, watercolor? What do you use? Acrylic, nice. And you box? All right, I'm not gonna mess with you then. Well, welcome. So let's go over how we do this class. Like I said, you're not copying these down. We're gonna read and then you're gonna respond to it. So you're expected to be in your seat when the bell rings with your computer logged in and your starter open. And then many of you saw on the screen, it says, hey, go to Nearpod and join. And you were already doing that. So when I'm going through my procedures, I have 20 of them. And so I use Nearpod to help communicate that. I want to embed the technology right off on day one. So the kids are interacting with it. Here's the procedure, we're gonna read it. Now let's answer this question, this application question, comprehension question. I wanna make sure you understand it. I wanna make sure you can make that connection between why it's important and why we do it in this class. All right, number 10. Food or drinks of any kind are not allowed in the computer lab. This is non-negotiable. If you need water, leave it at these tables. All right, so it's away from the computers. What I want you to do, think about, you have food or water or something at your computer. Draw what might happen if you have food or drink at your computer desk. I'm gonna give you 2 minutes to draw what might happen, predict what might happen. That looks great. All right, most of you focused on the water aspect, right? Where your computer might break because there's water on the keyboard or something like that. What about food?
Food will get stuck on there.
On the keys?
Yeah.
Yeah, that food will get stuck on there and then it'll just not be, it won't work right or it'll just be kind of gross. So I use a variety of the tools from Nearpod, so it's not just question, question, question. Some of them I have them draw. And then we have discussions after they draw on how it's related to the expectation and why that expectation is important. So they saw with the drawing where that comes into play. for the fire drill, instead of lining them up and walking them out there, walking them back, if I have them map it out, now they're consciously thinking, okay, yeah, no, I go to the evacuation area. So they're doing that thought process already and then having to explain it out. When you walk in through the door like you did today, quietly, voice level zero, you come over to this iPad. The camera is on the left side. Okay, there's a little box that shows it. You hold your QR code up to that, it'll beep, just like it did. I'll do it again. So we went through the procedures on day two and three, but we brought back all those procedures on multiple days throughout the day, constant repetition. So it's just 3 days where we've done the expectations, but then we start practicing it for the first 2 weeks. As we start introducing content, we're bringing it back for that practice over and over again. So that way they're meeting that expectation, meeting that procedure to make your teaching, my teaching, everything to be a lot more smoother so that you know your learning is the focus and not, again, here's how we do the tap lights. After 2 weeks, we're good.